A fountain of lava suddenly erupts high into the air, reaching a height of 100 meters. Lava from this fountain then falls back to the ground, generating a runny flow of molten rock. Over the next several months, this lava flow advances across the landscape, starting wildfires and producing abundant volcanic gases. While what I just described might sound like something which might occur in locations such as Iceland, believe it or not, this is exactly what occurred at a volcano in Australia within Queensland a mere 13,000 years ago. This eruption occurred at the Toomba Volcano, which, assuming it erupted at the same rate the Fagradalsfjall volcano did in Iceland during its 2021 eruption, emitted so much material that its eruption was continuous for 31 years and 7.5 months. During this time span, lava flows coated the landscape in sections up to 120 kilometers or 74.6 miles distant from its source vent, covering a grand total of 676 square kilometers and a thick layer of black volcanic rock. By the time this lengthy eruption had ended, a 70-meter or 230-foot-tall volcanic cone had been constructed at the eruption's primary vent. Today, this fascinating volcano and its lava field, which contain 10 cubic kilometers of volcanic rock, is so large that it can be easily spotted from orbit. This is somewhat close in terms of volume to the 14 cubic kilometers of lava the lackey vents of the Grímsvötn volcano in Iceland erupted during sections of 1783 and 1784, which released so much volcanic gases and aerosols around the planet that it created a famine which helped cause the French Revolution. However, existing human populations were not as severely affected by the Toomba volcano's eruption due to several factors. For one, its eruption was two orders of magnitude less explosive than Lackey, so various volcanic products were less likely to end up traveling high into the atmosphere. However, while Lackey produced 14 cubic kilometers of lava during an 8-month-long eruption, it took Toomba nearly 32 years to erupt a comparable 10 cubic kilometers. This means that the gases and aerosols it produced were dispersed in smaller amounts compared to Lackey, as a certain threshold of material in the atmosphere is needed to cause severe climatic and rainfall variations. The Toomba volcano is one of approximately 40 vents which exist in a 7,000 square kilometer region known as the Nulla Volcanic Province. This volcanic province has been active for a little more than 5 million years, with eruptions occurring on average about once every 120,000 years. These eruptions involve the creation of many other small shield volcanoes, with one remnant vent from an extinct eruptive center visible 27 kilometers west of Toomba's highest point. In another section of the volcanic field, there appears to even be highly eroded lava flows which are probably 100,000 to 200,000 years in age. As a whole, we are unsure why exactly this volcanic field exists, but we know it does not originate due to melting from plate subduction, a rift zone, or an underlying hotspot. The Nulla Volcanic Province is merely one of four active and dormant volcanic fields spanning the eastern half of Australia which have each produced volcanic eruptions at some point during the last 20,000 years. The other fields are the newer volcanics province in Victoria and South Australia, the McBride volcanic province in Queensland, and the Atherton basalt province in Queensland. While much of the extinct Toomba volcano is located in the Great Basalt Wall National Park, this name is actually somewhat misleading. This volcano does not actually contain any basalt, but rather two very similar types of slightly more alkali-rich volcanic rock. Most of the lava flow is made of the rock type trachybasalt, with another small section of it being composed of basanite. Of course, the Great Trachybasalt or Basanite Wall National Park does not have the same ring to the name. Although the Toomba Shield Volcano will never erupt again, there is always a possibility that the next eruption in the Nulla Field will open a new vent less than 1 kilometer away from Toomba's primary vent during its last eruption, or as much as 30 kilometers away. With this being said, there are rare circumstances where monogenetic vents do erupt more than once. This is why, although Toomba could probably be classified as extinct, I am classifying it, along with a broader Nulla Volcanic Province which it is a part of, as a dormant volcanic complex. Sadly, there is no public access to the Great Basalt Wall National Park, as it is surrounded by private property and people are specifically not allowed in the park, so you cannot visit it or walk/hike on the lava flows. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank Mr. Stephen Rudder for becoming a new patron on this channel's Patreon page.